Endpoint Manager allows you to distribute software to manage devices. In this example, we'll distribute a Windows MSI version of VLC, the media player from VideoLand software. In the console, click Distribution, Distribution Packages, My Packages. Click the New Toolbar button, and you'll see the supported distribution platforms and package types. For our package, we'll click Windows MSI. The MSI Properties dialog box opens. There are many options you can configure here. The two you'll always have to configure are Package Information and Install and Uninstall Options. On the Package Information page, enter a package name and description. Next, you need to browse for the package's primary file. This is the main file that launches the package installer. In our case, we only have a single MSI file, so we'll point to that. If the primary package file requires additional files to run, you can add them on the Additional Files page. Package files need to be placed on a web or file share that is accessible from clients. The default is an HTTP share on your core server located here. I've already downloaded the MSI version of the VideoLand VLC installer and placed it there. When I click the VLC MSI file, you can see the URL clients will use to access the file. You should test the resulting URL or share path from a client to make sure it works. On the Install Uninstall Options page, we'll make sure Install is selected since we're installing this package. You can also configure display options for what users will see during installation, along with reboot options if a post-installation reboot is necessary. At the bottom of the page, you can see a command line that will be used to install the package. You'll want to use a package command line that allows for a silent install with the options you want. MSI packages have standard options for a silent install, and those will be specified here automatically. The command line for executable installers varies and depends on the program you're installing, so you'll have to find those from the program's creator. We'll leave these at the default and click Save. The new package appears in the list. Right-click it and click Create Scheduled Task. The Scheduled Task tool opens with the task we created selected. The task isn't ready to run yet since we haven't specified the devices we want the task to target. Right-click the task and click Properties. On the Targets page, select the devices you want to receive the package. We're going to manually target a single device with the targeted device item, but you can easily target multiple devices with the other items. Select a target type and click the Add button. Select the targets you want, and then click OK. Back in the Targeted Items tree, you can see the targets you selected. Go ahead and click Save. The Task Properties dialog box closes, and we're back in the Scheduled Tasks view. To begin the distribution to our targeted device, right-click the task and click Start Now, All. Monitor task progress in the Scheduled Tasks view. When the task is done, it should move to the Successful row.